Hello guys, it's SciShark here, Valentino Journal. Those are my two electronic music projects. SciShark is for psytrance, and Valentino Journal is for other type of electronic music, such as uplifting trance, techno, and other types. So today we are going to learn how to produce an electronic music track. It doesn't matter if it's psytrance, psychedelic trance, or uplifting trance, house, anything you like. It's the same rules, the same basics. So music style doesn't matter, but I will show you the basic tools. Okay, and I would like to introduce for you some of my tracks, just to let you know what I produce. For example, if you go to beatport.com, beatport, as you see here, URL, search for PsyShark, it's PSY, and the word shark, SHARK, enter. You can find all my releases if you click on PsyShark. Then go to my last album, Return of PsyShark. Can pick any track. For example, I will take last one, Metaphysics, and this is how it sounds. A lot of hallucinated sounds. I like those sounds, trippy sounds. Okay, now I will let you listen to my other project, Valentino Journal, also at Beatport. By the way, you can find my tracks anywhere at Amazon.com, iTunes, and many websites. So, Valentino Journal, as you see, I'm searching, and last album, it's called Festival 1. Let's pick the first track, it's called Electronizer. It sounds like that. Okay, as you see, listen, it's another style, it's not psychedelic, but still trance and energetic. Okay, let's go to Cubase. So, as I said before, you can produce any track, any style you like. The tools that you will get now can let you produce any track, any musical track you like. So, by the way, it doesn't matter what software you use, if it's Cubase, Fruity Loops, Reason, Ableton, Pro Tools, Logic Audio, and many more. The final result, what determines if the track is good or not, it's you, it's not the software. So there's no magic buttons into Cubase or other programs. All work the same. So it's just, if you know the tools in one program, you can use the same tools at other programs. It's the same concepts. Okay, I will use Cubase because I'm used to it. Okay, so okay, what we are going to do now is clicking on file, then new project. We are going to select empty template. Now you can save the folder anywhere you like, it doesn't matter where. I recommend external hard drives and always backup your projects, because if you lose them, it's not a good feeling. I had this nightmare before. Anyway, just for the demonstration, it doesn't matter where I save it, click OK. Now, there are endless ways to start a track. Each artist has his own method, okay? So, my method is not the only one, and it's not probably the best one. And there is no best method. Any method you use can work. If it works for you and you are satisfied, then keep using it. Don't follow other artists, just learn from them tips. Okay, so many people ask me, how do you start a track? What's the first thing? Well, there is no specific one answer. You can start with a kick, bass drum, you can start with a melody, you can start with anything you like. By the end, if you have a full track and working, that's the main thing. But for making it simple, always it's common to start with a bass, because it's very simple, very very simple. Electronic music, 4 beats. Okay, now what I'm going to do is looking for a kick, bass drum. Sorry that I'm quick. If my steps are quick, just click pause each time. I will try to explain anything I do. So you go here, open the pool, then click on import, and you should know where the folder of your waves exists. It depends where you put it. I use many types of ready waves. Also, I can teach you in other tutorials how to produce your own waves. So from Laziness, we will take Vengeance. They have good sound samples. Okay, I will look inside into bass drums, and I will pick a Trancy kick. There are many kicks here. You can pick anything you like, there is no rules. I like it punchy and fat, so I will take this one. Let this checkbox checked. It means to copy the file to working directory. So if you move the directory of the project, the waves will be inside, will not be missing. Click OK, right click on the wave, insert into project, add cursor. Now close this this window of the pool. Now you can see the kick here. Okay, let's see that I'm recording it. Okay, still recording. Now we have your kick. Okay, now I will teach you also one more thing. It's not only about putting the waves and writing the track. One of the methods that I use, I learned alone, is to make arrangement. It's in any field in life, it's good to make arrangement if you wanna make your life better. And what is this problem? Let's see. Okay, yeah. Software problems. Anyway, so as I said, when you arrange things at any field in your life, you can find things better, easier. So also in cubes is the same. Don't just throw the waves, make some arrangement. I will show you what I mean by that. So for making quick loop, you might put 4 kicks. At one channel, click F2, you will have this menu. We'll set it on 146 BPM. It doesn't matter what BPM you use, it's a matter of taste. And now you have a loop of 4 kicks. Sorry, I made a mistake. is a quick loop, but this is not this is not the thing that I wanted to show you. Let's make arrangement. First of all, save the track. File, save, or you can click Control S. Then let's call the track T1, for example. T1, I already have saved a track like this. Click save, and yes. Then click save as. To make another copy, you can click Control Shift S, shortcut. And write the same name, T1-backup. So why we do this? From my bad experience in the past, I lost a file, CPR file, it's the project file. So when that happened, I couldn't open the file, all the project was corrupted and I was screwed. I had only the waves, but I could rearrange them, but it was difficult because there were a lot of waves. So now you have two copies, and every time you make any change, click Control S, save, then Control Shift S, and save to the other file. Save two copies always, every change. You must do it. Do it as a habit. Every little change, because you don't know what will happen. But I will teach you another method that I learned alone. Even if both files are corrupted, you still have the ways, and there is a method that I did that you can construct the track even without having the CPR file, even without having this file, just by naming the waves. And I will show you what I mean without confusing you. We'll get to it step by step. It means then you can construct the track again and have it. But if you lose all the waves, all the computer, for example, exploded, burned, whatever, then no way to get it back. So, how to start a track? We put here 4 kicks, but before that, let's make arrangement. What is the arrangement that I mean? It starts with the locators, markers, sorry. Right click here, choose add marker track, put it at the top, and start marking your track. That means I choose bar here, right click at this bar, choose bars and beats, zoom out till you see those numbers 1, 17, 33, 49, 65, etc. And start marking. By the way, my method, as I said before, is not the only method. It's working for me, it's making my life easier. Probably for you too. You can accept that or not, but I'm just sharing with you the tips. You can keep putting markers as you want. If you click F2, for example, I want a track that is consisted of 6.5 minutes. Most of my tracks are like this. So I will keep going till I get till here, 241. So it will be like this. Another marker here, another one here, here, and here. It's not aligned yet. We will do it again. Now, I'm doing this. I will tell you right now. First, zoom in to see if it's aligned. It's aligned. 33 aligned. 41 aligned. 65 aligned. By the way, we are doing this because we are building a template. You can reuse this template for other tracks and reconstruct, but basically you would use the same template. As you see, it's not aligned under 97, so we put it here. Okay, so same issue here, 113, I should put it here. can use this zoom out only. Also here it's not aligned, 129, 29, 45, 161. By the way, it's, if those tips are boring, you can skip forward for the track production, but I recommend that you make those steps. 193, 209, 202, and last one. Okay, we are almost done. 15 minutes just explaining to you how to arrange. Why I did that? Simply, for example, now I select number one, I will call it intro. Now it's called intro. Each two locators are consisted of around 30 seconds, it's 26. So intro will be for me. You can do any intro or you can leave it. Okay, so it will be 30 seconds. Now from the second bar, I will call it warming up. You can call it pizza, anything you like. I call it warming up. It will be 1 minute of warming up, just building progression. Stay in progress. Okay, warming up. I will call it again. Warming up for me, it means not get into the full power of the track. Now I might have a little break here. This is how I construct my track, not all the tracks, but just a method, just to give you an idea. Okay, let's say I will have a break for 30 seconds. Break plus building tension, so it will be break and tension, 50 seconds break and 50 seconds tension. This bar is break and tension. Then from this bar it will be action. I call it action. I mean all the war will begin. The track will be at its maximum power. Now you can keep on and do anything you like here. Add many breaks, slowing down, getting faster, play with the pace, doing it. There is no limits for your imaginations. Okay, I'm just giving you simple tips here. So I can leave the intro for later, or I can do it right now. But anyway, I will start to make my first loop at the warming up. I will leave the intro. Intro, it's something that I work on slowly, and it's not the time to waste. It's not the good time to waste time on it. Okay, so let's get into the loop part. So we have here four kicks, but we are still not done. You should add also folders. Those folders are made to make your sequencer and arrangement looks better for your eyes, for your accessibility. First folder I will call it rhythm or kick and bass, whatever you like. As I said, if you understand it, this is the main thing. You do it for yourself, not for others. But even others will understand it if you give the project, provide it to someone else. Cymbals, percussions. Second folder, this one I will call it vocals. If I need, this one is bass. This one I will call it melodies. This one will be, you can add as many as you want. FX, and also I will add another track, a folder, it's MIDI. all the MIDI file MIM channels. Okay, now I have all folders. I will put the channel of the kick here at the kick and bass. Now I have four kicks. Now I will make a short loop just to demonstrate what we are doing. Now I need to put baseline. Click F11 or go to devices, then VST instruments. You can use any VST baseline you like. There is no best or top baseline. It's a matter of taste only. I used many baselines on my tracks. Now I use this one just because I like it, but I might use more VST instruments. It's called G-Sonic Alien 303. Okay, if it asks if we need a MIDI track, click yes, create. Now it's added here. You can see it. This is the plugin. I opened a MIDI track. You can put it here, but specifically only the baseline. I will add it also here under the folder of kick and bass. If I close this folder, now you see that everything is collapsed and beautiful. You can expand or collapse the folders. Okay, so I will expand this folder. Now I will need to write baseline notes. Okay, baseline notes. You have already presets here, and you can tweak them. You can pick anything you like. Let's say fat bass. Let's hear how it sounds. Not bad. There, as I said, there are endless methods of doing this stuff that I'm showing you now. Okay, one of the tips that I can show you, if you can't hear the note, I trust my ears, but you can go to insert and put here a plugin called, I think it's a built-in plugin, I'm not sure about that. It's called, wait, I will tell you right now, Tuner. It will show you the note of the kick. It's around between 60 hertz to 65, note C or B. You can do another thing. You can click on the kick, hold control button, right click, and go to I'm teaching you here to build a track, and by the same time little tips about sound. So 2-in-1 I hope to achieve in this tutorial. Click on spectrum analyzer, then process, then check the boxes dB and frequency. Then you can see that at the peak the kick is 65 hertz. Look at the right corner. This is where it's dominant. The tuner shows the same thing. Let me show you. Remember 65, 64, it's the same. So why it helps us, if you want to put also a baseline and you can't hear what note is the best, you can also add a tuner for the baseline. As we had seen for the kick, it was C, around C or B. So we will pick note C or note C or B or whatever you like. We should match between the kick and bass. Let them sound cool. So just for the demonstration, choose CNode. You can't choose anything you like, okay? It's not a music lesson. Okay, you can also add the tuner. The VST instrument exists under VST instruments folder. You can also bring it up to this folder, kick and bass. So you will have everything here. You can add the tuner also. It shows us that it's C, but it's 15 hertz. It's a little bit heavy. Sorry, too low. Control I to select. Now it sounds better. Okay. We have kick and bass, but we didn't finish. There are endless tweaks you can do to the bass line. Okay, now it sounds like this. You can play with the note length. It's a matter of taste. Okay, so there is no a basic one rule. Now you can play with a VST synthesizer. Okay, let's see. Now we can play with the notes. Okay, it's only a simple rolling bass line. You can do anything you like, okay? Now we can do more tweaks. Click on that channel of the bass line, then go to MIDI insert and choose a quantizer. Play with the settings here. By the way, you can choose any plugin from those and listen to the baseline and how it changes. Okay, so for example, a quantizer swing, as you hear, you can put a simple loop just to break all the rhythm suddenly. It works very well at the dance floor. Then you can get back to what you had. just a tip, you know, there's endless options. It's very cool to play with it. Okay, you can play also with the quantized note. Just playing with it, and you can choose whatever you like. Whatever you like. Okay. As you see, you can do many things and there's endless of possibilities. So, we are not done yet. Now we get to the funny part, to put effects on the bassline. Go to the other insert of the VST and let's remove that tuner, we don't need it. Also from the kick. Remove anything you don't want in order to save CPU. Now you can put many effects and get many sounds. Whatever sounds good for you, use it. Go to distortion for example and add distortion for the kick, or you can add other distortion called EQ. Then you can go to, there is another cool one, I will show you it. It's called, it's used a lot in psytrance tracks, but some artists keeps things as secret. It's funny. It's not nuclear weapon. They don't like to share. This one, Beach Crusher. It's very cool. It can add a lot to the bassline. Add some punch and you can play with it, tweak it till you get the sound that you like, okay? As you hear, it gets more punch, or it sounds more with high frequency, okay? And you can also add it, let's hear the difference. If I will disable all the plugins I've added effects to the baseline, it will sound like that. You may like it with or without, it's your taste. Then you can add equalizer. I'm using the Cubase built-in plugins. You should not use other plugins. You can, but certainly you don't need, because everything is available in Cubase. And if you just take the project, install new Cubase, for example, I'm using Cubase 5, If you use later versions, it's okay also. When you use older one, then you simply load the project and everything will be there. Okay, let's look for EQ. I will use Studio EQ, I think. Also, yeah, it's built-in EQ. We need to handle some low frequencies at the bass. As you hear, I'm cutting by bare bass a lot, just to let you hear the differences. Or add a lot. It's ugly now. Now you don't have anything. So you should play with the EQ if it's needed, not always. Also, you can add effects for the kick. You don't need, but you can add the same effect that I have added before. This one, the Beat Crusher. Let's hear the kick with a Beat Crusher. Be careful not to overuse it, because it will be as noise in the ears. So you need the punch, but don't overuse it or cut it by EQ at the high frequencies. So use your ears. I'm just showing you the tools. Those presets I'm doing, just for example. Okay, so let's add also EQ here. EQ and the same one. And you can see it's called the bass drum EQ, and I can right click always on top and then open the other EQ of the alien. Now what I'm going to do is try to match between the, to make ugly no kick you can make it punchy. Can add more to the main frequency, it's 65. We can play with all features till you get the sound that you desire. Okay, we will not continue doing this because it may take a lot of time. So if I close all the insert effects, it will sound like this. Listen, it was without effects. With effects, it will sound like this. Whatever you like, if you like it with effects, without effects, it's your taste. Okay, so the next thing that we can do. I close this folder. Now we don't have kick and bass. Okay, now we should add samples. Okay, samples. Samples. Let's try put close height. Again, it's your taste. There is no magical close height. It's here. We'll put it in the folder of samples. By the way, we didn't set the volume at the mixer of the kick and bass, so we can do it. Let's set it to -10 RMS. F3 will bring you the mixer. It now indicates 5. You should look here, not at this one, at this one, the dynamic numbers. Now it's around -9, -10. Same thing for the baseline. Okay, you can use your ears, but also you can use the numbers here. Always get to the lowest point and to the highest point, then start tweaking. You don't need always the numbers, but if you're not sure, go for the numbers. Let the kick be, sorry, a simple rule of thumb, but not always true, specifically in psytrance productions. Let the kick be sound louder than the bass line. So if we have here, for example, 9, let the bass line be -10, 10.5, and it sounds very cool. Now, okay, now let's listen to our sample. Now if I close this group, you see it looks now way clear, more comfortable for you, it's clearer. One more thing cool about the groups, you can mute all the group together or release it together. So I need to listen only to the close height. It's very loud. I need 16 of it to be to this bar. But it's not aligned, as you hear. This is why we have zoom in and zoom out. Hold the Alt button and move with the mouse left button and put it under those numbers, and just be sure that when you use quantize, it's set 1 to 16, then align it to the numbers, like this, then you can get all the group. You can do it also by another way, select Control D. Now you can select all the group, hold the control button, shortening it, and do one more thing, fade it out like this, because sometimes there's clicky sound at the end of the wave, but it sounds very loud. Let's put it at -20, then listen to everything together, then if it needed to be more louder, we will do it. Okay, you can put it like this, it's ugly, or you can't hear it, or you always start from the lowest point, then mute. Then try to listen, if you listen to it or not. If you put it like this, you think it's good, but shut it down, then release it, you listen. listen that it's too loud. So start from the lowest point. Now we have rhythm that sounds very cool and tight. Okay, now we have to put open hi-hat. We're just building. By the way, I told you before that you should save, and me myself didn't save. Control S, then Control Shift S, and save to backup. Make sure and save to the other copy. Okay, we need now open height. Again, it's your taste. Let's pick randomly something. That goes off. Now look, it's here. When I was at the pool and right click on it and clicked on insert into project at cursor, it was dropped onto the channel of the closed height. So here we can see the colors. It's brown. It's very simple how to remove it. Just drag and drop it to the end. If you can't, just right click, make add new channel, audio track, and then you will have another track, and you can put it into it. Okay, but now we don't need that track. I will remove it. One more thing, click on the E, next to it. Always, if you don't have anything attached, click on the no bus, because from my experience you might hear internal sounds that you don't want into your track. Same thing into MIDI channels. If you add later, right click MIDI channel, by default it has Microsoft blah 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 GS wavetable sign. Click on not connected, or you will hear sounds by ear for headphones. You will hear it. Artifacts, it's not good for your track. Okay, let's remove this one. Remove this one. Now we have the height. We'll put it in the symbols folder. Okay, if we look at the track, looks like we have a mess here. But again, close the folders. Hocus pocus, everything looks nice. We need to work on the symbols. Height. Height you put, sorry. Open height, yeah, you put it on the first of all. We should make it short. Hold the control button, do this thing. If you want a guideline, open the folder of kick and bass. Under each offbeat of the kick, you can put 1.3, so the sound it's too loud, and it's okay to be too loud. Okay, this is the 1.3, 2.3. It's the offbeat of the kick. We select both together. We go to 0.3, if you see here, and it's all aligned. Yeah, it sounds a little bit ugly. You can handle it by the inside equalizer here. You don't need to add every time in the insert equalizer. Go to the left one and click on high pass. Cut all the low frequencies that you don't hear in the hi-hat. Then click here. You can add more high frequencies as you wish, till it sounds good. There's no rules for how much you need to add. If it sounds good, it's good. can play with the length of the height. It will sound like that. I will make it higher, louder, just to let you listen to it. To the changes. Okay, so it's a matter of taste again. You can play with that. One more thing that you should know, always cut all the high frequency, low frequencies. Go to all channels and separate it, solo state call. Then F3 and go to edit audio channel settings and cut all the low frequencies, high pass. High pass, it means only the high frequencies pass. Because no one hears the low frequency of this thing, of the hi-hat. So it only disturbs for the low frequencies of the kick bass drum, but it's only dominant here at this area. Okay, just another tip. Back to the bass line. If you don't like this bass line, you can play with the dynamics of the notes. The velocity, it gives more dynamics. Now it sounds more energetic. It was like this before. Now it's like this. This is the rhythm. Let's add hi-hat. Claps. can add as many you want. There are many techniques. You can put a lot of claps, and we should choose different tracks when you select both. And we will have again one other tracks, but simply drag and drop. I will put them under symbols. Okay, now we have the claps. Clap with the on each second kick. And there is a nice technique that you can use. First, let's make adjust the volume. Snap off the quantizer, then bring it a few steps behind the kick. This is the kick. This is the first clap. It's aligned with the kick. And this is the second kick. It's a few steps behind. Don't do it too much behind. I will let you hear how it will sound. Only kick and claps. Now listen, when I remove it a little bit behind, how it will sound. You can play with the other kick, not only that. Ugly. Let's choose the other one. I'm just showing you the methods, techniques, but you can use any sound you like, then reach any result you like. Zoom in and you can hear the result with and without. Okay, I'm playing with the EQ laser of the kick. I want more punch on the kick. if you want to add more punch to the kick, you can bring another clause. Symbols. Ride or close height, whatever you like. Something with punch, a lot of punch, and ringing. For example, this one, it doesn't matter. Just for the demonstration. And under each kick, you can add it to add more punch. Some artists may agree, some no, but it works for me, so I don't care what others does. I do. Then you can play with it. There is no rules. Okay, this one I will put it under, not symbols, under the kick folder. Let's close, collapse all folders to make some clarity. Now we have this symbol in this folder of the kick. We will put it under the kick because it will be aligned with the kick, but make it short. When I mean say short, also the sound should be need the clicky sound of it. So, make it as short as possible. We need only the punch, the clicky sound. This is how we will get a punchy kick. More punch to the kick. Put it to the maximum, louder, loudest point, then to the lowest, then to the middle, then up to the middle, under the middle, then find the correct point. Shut down, bring it back. You will hear a difference. Again, we should treat like a laser. Always, always, always cut the low frequencies. And you can boost a little bit if you want the high frequencies, but not too much. Let's hear the kick without any effect. This is the kick without any effect. This is the kick with the symbol we have added to it. This is the kick with the effects. It's way better. Listen again. We lost the punch, now we have punch. All together. I will close, I will remove the symbol and the effects from the kick, and you will note the difference. this is the rhythm. There's endless possibilities to do. I'm just showing you a few main things to get professional and fat sound, punchy sound. There's more things to do. This is our main loop. We can add more and more. Now I will show you the funny part. Everything is funny actually. Those guys. Okay, now one more tip for you. If you want to duplicate the channel, selecting all of this, it's pain in the ass. So there is a method that I found. Just right click, add a MIDI track. You can simply copy all of this, select and control D, but sometimes you see what happens here, it's not aligned. I mean, all of these should be here. In order to avoid this problem, right click, add MIDI track. It's not used for anything. You put it on the symbol on the top, and our procedure, remove this, not connected, in order to avoid artifacts and all that dirty sounds that the computer produces, the sound card. Double click, you will have now all everything connected, glued together. If I remove it, you see there are holes, it's splitted. But now when you put that, when I double clicked here, it's all glued together. So if you click here and click Control D, it will put them aligned exactly at the same place. Copy paste method, but it works very fine. Now it makes your life better. So same for the kick. The kick, we don't need to add MIDI file because it exists already. So we can do like this. Now if you want to make the life little bit faster, select all of this, Control D, Control D, then select again Control D. We have some problem. Let's see what's happening here. Why this happens? Let's see. For some reason. Okay, I know it. Let's handle the kick first. You can later cut the kicks, but if you wanna duplicate them, just Control D. And you see, you can fill the whole track with the kicks. But for sure, don't build a track without breaks and only kicks. Just showing you methods, okay? Now the little work that we have invested here, actually not little work, it's around 1 hour, because I'm explaining. Now we have it at all the track. But let's close it. Now we had a problem here, it's splitting here. The reason is you should open it, then select it like this way. Let me see now. What's happening here? Figure out, it didn't happen before to me. Now this is the time to investigate what the issue is that is happening here, because it worked before. Weird. there's another method. If it happens, you can glow all the waves. I don't like to do it like this way. There are many methods, okay? So you can click here and you can glow it. So let me delete everything. If the MIDI method doesn't work, just the glow, 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 okay? And the same thing here. Now we don't have any problem, as you see. Just you need to glow it, but you should also keep the MIDI file. And what we have here looks like has finished track, but it's not. It's just the rhythm, and we will re-edit the rhythm. You should edit it. Now you can select all the group. It saves time. Now we have problem. But you got the idea what I'm explaining now. Okay, you know, I will do it in purpose because it's pissing me off if it's not working. Some hole here. I'm trying to zoom in. Shit. Control Z will roll back. Control Shift Z will redo. Okay. Okay, now it's working again. Again. And that's it. For sure you can cut later any part that you don't need anything, but now we have all the rhythm. It's exactly aligned at all the points we have decided before. So you have learned those techniques to make groups, to glow things, to put MIDI file in order, to duplicate the group with all channels under it. It will save for you time. Imagine that you would write each wave separately and you have 100 channels, for example. You will get lost for many hours. Now, with a few seconds, you can do it. Now we close everything. You can add as much as you want to any part, breaks, and add more to the samples, but it's only showing you the basics. Now let's go to the MIDI file and click F11. And till now, we have only one VST. Now I will use my favorite VST instrument, Albino 3. It's for effects mainly. That for many things, but I like to use it for effects. Okay, so need to put a serial. I hope I have presets, because if not, I need to do. Okay, those are default presets. I don't like them. For sidetrans, remember the locators that I did warming up? I want to make a loop consistent of Okay, I'm pressing F2. If this problem happens to you, it means that something in the graphic card is happened. So this is the solution. I found it on the internet, googling it one time. Screen resolution, if I'm not mistaken, yes, and you should play with the resolution. It's good that we have such problems so you can learn. Keep changes, then go F2. It didn't solve it, then you can do it again. Right click, screen resolution. Let's make it to the lowest part. Keep changes. Now this bitch should work. Sorry for my dirty words. Okay. I will fight with it till it's resolved. Either way. I had this problem. I hope that you don't have it. Because it's like the here we go. It's back. When it's back, we can get our resolution back to the main thing. And shit, I feel that like I'm like that I'm at a restaurant TV show, food show. Okay, we have it here. My favorite instrument, Albino 3. Let's see what we have, my friend. By the way, this demonstration might be a track someday, you know. I will leave it called D1 and I will provide it to you with all presets, everything. I'm not like other artists that don't like to share. I don't mean that I'm the best, but I mean there's no reason to hide things. It's good to share stuff. By stuff I mean music, not other stuff. Okay, my keyboard is not connected. I'm lazy, I should connect it. I don't hear any sound. I don't hear any sound because I think the serial. Silent one is good, but I use it for. It's good for my other project, not for Psytrance. Let's use. My other favorite one, Discovery. I like trippy sounds. This is why I know Albino 3 very good, so the only reason I use it a lot. So. Okay. Presets, I need to do from the start.
presets. Because I had a hard drive crash. Let me connect my keyboard because it's not a good way to work like this. Wait. Ugly sounds. Okay, those sounds sound for me cool. You know, I didn't do anything, only playing with the oscillator. The preset called A5 2H Pate. It's a default preset at Discovery. Okay, and what we can do with this is recording it. Or automating it. We'll do both methods. It's a matter of laziness and preference. There's benefits from each method and vice versa. My first mistake. Okay, it's just simple sound, nothing complex. The thing that you should learn now, how to explore this sound. What I did here, I've recorded the automation, so it sounds like this. This bitch sometimes doesn't work. You should go to the editor and look for the when you see a star next to go to the editor, click on this arrow, look for the star. It means there's the automation, and then you can play with it. the same note. Let's say it's going like this. Let's put it always on top. And let's see that. You know what? Actually, I did a mistake. I have the map for this synthesizer, for this VST. It's called, there's also for Zeta, no, but it's not. Okay, it's number 78. You can download it. You can also take it from me. Just take a photo for it. 78. We look for 78 here. Setup. Always, when you don't know any option, look at Google. You can find many solutions. 70, I already forgot. My memory is fucked up. 78. By the way, I can leave it open. Now we should drag it to this point. Click OK. And if I click here, I see 78. Now I can control it. That son of a bitch, I can control it now. And let's make it. Okay, let's take the pen and let's see what will happen if we do like this. Okay, the more you go to the, it's very simple. Left side, it's here. And right side, it's for the right side. Means when you do a selector to the right, left side, it's for here. Right side for here. So we can play with the sounds as we want. And you can paint however you like, with parabola, sinus, you can do like this way or the opposite direction. They don't have it, maybe they have this one. Ugly, stinky. Actually, I don't use all of these, but I like to paint like this. This will be our last demonstration, because from here you should build your own track. There's no, I will share with you short tips every time. Even make it faster. You can do it like this. Can do something else like that. Going up, going down very fast. There's endless possibilities. This is the fun of producing psytrons, psychedelectrons. There's endless possibilities. just for the fucking demonstration, we can cut this thing. I'm using the word fucking too much. It's not good. Now you will say I don't behave as a nice person. What you need to do is click on file, export, mix down, and here's the funny part. You should choose here the folder, use project folder. I used to call the names like that, as the name of the track, always, it's the first suffix. T1, for example, the name of the track, dash. The position of the wave, it exists at 0.17. If you really want it here, write 17. If you don't, why I'm saying that, now you know. At this point, I will not put it at 17, maybe, let me see. Okay, I will put it at 17, okay? But anyway, this method is good only for one reason. Okay, one, you put 17, and you can call it discovery. Disc. Or discovery as you want. It means the name of the synthesizer. Now we will put it at pool track close after 41. It's good to put 48, 32 bit float export. What happens here? Convert the project. Ignore it. Let's see the project. I don't remember what I set it for. It's 44. Anyway, let's mute this sound. Don't delete it. Now you have the wave here. Next time, if your both files CPR are corrupted, you can reconstruct this project when you have many files only by their names. This is a very good tip. I learned it alone from bad experiences when I lost my projects. Always backup, but do it also. If it's written here 17, you know that you should put it at 17. You can take all waves. If it's 25 and you have, for example, three waves that are indicating 25, you would put it at different channels, 25, 25, 25, this one 17, and etc. for all the wall track. And here we go, you have your wall track constructed. Very cool. Okay, now we can manipulate this sound. Tricks, for example, now when I enter this track, I can do this always on top, means to stick it at the window. And you can record, click WR, the events, the filter. Then right click and show all used automation, and what you get here, remove the W first of all and leave it with R in order to see the record that you did. You can play with the filters same way I did before for other automation, and you know it's cool. This one is the gain, we don't need it. Oh, only with one effect, just to show you what you can do with only one effect. I'm adding effects, any effect you like to achieve the sound you like. Just play with it. World modulation. You can duplicate the tracks and you'll have more tracks. I have duplicated the track, but I will remove the chorus and will remove the first part. Now, I will show you. First of all, let's move them to effects folder. This is where they should be. Albino should be here. All MIDI tracks put in this folder. This audio folder, when you zoom out, you see that it has nothing. Just delete it. Anything you don't use, just delete. Okay, we have this loop at the FX, and let's see how many times it returns. We'll be right back. Okay, as you see, it's only one effect and we are already constructing something that sounds finished, but it's not. There will be a lot of effects and effects and sounds and melodies and more and more and more and more. And this is the way how you should work, building up slowly. Add crash. We didn't add crash. Too loud. Crashy. Okay, 2 hours. Wow. Where's our crash? Let's search for it. Crashy, where are you? Maybe I didn't add it. Or maybe I did, but it's hidden somewhere. Simply I did it. Didn't crash, maybe this one. Right click. Shouldn't do this. Remove from both. Okay, new. At version, it means at the beginning, if I'm not mistaken. And this is the easiest way to find it. Put as bar to pay, put it exactly at the first point. Crash should be loud, but not too loud. Not to kill the kick, but to complain for it. To make it sound exciting. For now, it's too loud. The kick then. Somehow it's added with effect. It should not. You should remove it. Go to. Wait. What's happening here? Was without effect, sorry. Because I have two crashes, this is the reason why we have another crash. Let's see where it is. It should, in here is it. Okay. Let's see if it sounds good. We'll be right back. importing the crash to symbols folder, and it sounds still a little bit loud. Loud for me. Now it's better. Playing with the open height. Let's play with the bass. Baseline. Sounds when it will be boosted. Now I'm using just a simple preset of D-Rex. It's for mastering, okay, so just for the fun. It kills my CPU. Let's use something else. I have another one, Ozone. It's also a good one. Maybe it will be more more, I don't know what to say. Okay. With the zone and without. I'm not making mastering, just pushing the volume, raising it, to make it louder. We'll be right back. And I think it's enough, and from this point you can continue building the track to wherever you want. Those are the basics. Only one concept I didn't show you, it's called sidechain. I can show you it, it's very simple. You know what, let me see, let's invest another few minutes to show you it, because you probably will use it when you do pads. Sidechain, it's when you play the kick, other sounds under the sidechain channel will be muted. It gives a beautiful and nice sound. It's used a lot in dance music, also in psychedelic trance, but especially in anything with pads, you know, with all those sounds that doesn't end quickly, so it gives some motion, dynamic to the sound. Let's add group channel. Into this channel, I put Gotta Dynamics and choose compressor. It's built in. You should activate sidechain. And you should send the kick. Each time there's a kick, you can use another channel that has 4 beats, except of the kick. But each time the kick is played, you can send it to the sidechain channel. Now each sound that is played under the sidechain channel, let's say a silent one, let's choose any pad. It has pads. Where are you? I'm not going to prepare one. Let's see. Okay, let's take this just for example. To do is to put the output in this group. So it sounds like this. When the kick is played, the side chain. Okay, I did some mistake. Let's see what my mistake is. happening here to my friend that is called Silent One. Probably I did a little mistake. It happens, you know, sometimes. I just used the wrong group, that's it. I should use right click and group channel, then stereo. Then you put the compressor. You activate sidechain, okay, and you go to Silent One, assign the sizer that you are using, and it should be played from group one. You can call it sidechain, so you recognize it next time when you click on any sign that you want to send to sidechain. By the way, don't send all channels to sidechain. I used to do it once. For example, all those channels. By the way, you can put all those channels under one group and you can control them to lower the volume at one time. It's also another tip. I will not show you it because it's not that critical thing. It's better that you manually use each channel sometimes so you will not get used only to one group. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not. It depends. We go to the kick. We will resend it back to sidechain compressor. Open it. Now listen to the difference when the sidechain is activated and when it's not. Now it's not activated and the pad is playing with a kick. Now I will activate the sidechain. One more thing for you, because I think that before I did something that is okay, not wrong, but let me verify it for you. I want to insert another sidechain. You can play with the buttons, ratio, etc, to get any sound you like. Okay, it's not something absolute that you use always. I mean, there is no specific preset. Okay. This one off. Okay, you can forget about this one. I just was testing something. But the side chaining that I showed you before is the right one. Okay, so in order not to confuse you, we put the side chain at the kick. Sorry, we send. Let's do it again. Right click. Right click, and you add a group channel. Stereo one. Click OK. Then go to the insert, add compressor, and when you add this compressor, activate the side chain. After it, you go to the VST plugin and go to the output and you choose side chain group, not this one, this one group. Then you go to the kick. Each time there is kick, you go to the sense of the kick. You choose the side chain here and just send it to the maximum and play it. Without side chain, with side chain. All together. Without sidechain. With sidechain. Sounds way better. Let me just make one more thing. As our procedure. Lowering the sounds, cleaning, making EQs, compressing. I didn't touch all this stuff. Just showing you the basics. My friends, we are done. I will prepare more tutorials for you. It was the longest one, 2 hours and 10 minutes, even more. I hope that you have learned something, and if you have any requests, I will do my best to do more tutorials for you, and I will have free time. Have a good time and good luck with your career, hobbies, anything you do in life. See you. And if you like it, share it please, and spread psychedelia. Ciao, Valentino, Psyshark.